The 32-year-old Tiger, whose real name is Dick Hietu, is the British Empire middleweight champion and is ranked third among the world middleweights. He has won five in a row, including knockouts of Wilfie Greaves, Gene Armstrong, and Spider Webb. In all, he has won 42, lost 12, fought two draws, and has scored 13 KOs. He has never been stopped. The 23-year-old Pickett, who was making his first appearance on national TV, is substituting for Florentino Fernandez, who was delayed by travel difficulties and who will fight the winner in January. Pickett, coming into the bout as an underdog, is faced with a tremendous opportunity. A victory over Tiger would project him high in the middleweight picture. He has a fine record, having won 24 out of 25, scoring 14 KOs. His lone loss was by a knockout to Johnny Clyde last year. Pickett is 5 feet 11, while Tiger is 5 feet 8. At the Boxing Commission weigh-in today, Tiger was 160 and a half, while Pickett was a pound lighter. In just a few minutes, the 10-round middleweight fight between Billy Pickett and Dick Tiger will get underway. And now let's get up to a personable ring impresario, Johnny Eddy.
Ladies and gentlemen, two boxing shows at the St. Nicholas Arena next week, Monday night and next Saturday night. We'll go from the St. Nicholas Arena. We have a very good welterweight attraction. Isaac Logard will meet the former welterweight champion of the world, Emil Griffith, in the main event of 10 rounds. Here, ladies and gentlemen, in the ring, the former national Golden Glove champion, national AAU champion, the 1960 Olympic champion, and as a professional, he's undefeated in 10 bouts, scoring 7 knockouts, anxious to meet any heavyweight in the world. From Louisville, Kentucky, let's give him a nice welcome, Cassius Clay. Cassius Clay. Here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Tony Rossi, Frank Forbes, timekeeper George Bannon,
what the eye said,
counting for the knockdown, Johnny Poland, referee for the main event, Mark Kahn, 10 rounds, from White Plains, New York, wearing white trunks, he weighs 159 and a half, Billy Pickett, his opponent from Nigeria, wearing black trunks, weighing 160 and a half, recognized as the British Empire middleweight champion, Dick Tiger. Main event, 10 rounds, another bout to follow.
Listen carefully, Billy. Dick, you're boxing under the New York State rules. You keep both hands free when you're punching. You do not fall with one hand and hit with the other. Is that clear? When I see you locked in a clinch, I'm going to tell you to break. I want both of you to stop punching immediately and step back out of the clinch. Be careful of fouls, low blows, rapid blows, and kidney punches. And if you get knocked out in a punch, you must take an eight count. Shake hands now, come out boxing. Good luck.
Scoring here in New York is on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system if the rounds come out even on an official's card. There's a mandatory eight count and a three knockdown rule. If a man has scored three times in a round, that's it. You can see that Billy Pickett in the white trunks is much the taller of the two and opening fast. Tiger wearing the black. Pickett thought he'd catch the Tiger cold, and maybe he did. You can see that Pickett is much the taller of the two. Tiger likes to keep the hands close to the body on defense. He's a rugged fighter. He's never been stopped. Pickett is a boxer puncher, as you can see. First main event here.
Ladies
Pickett will faint with his head a lot. He also did a Kid Gavilan dance there. It's quite possible that Tiger may have no sense of humor, however. Tiger is a stalking type of fighter. Very patient. Pickett has a strong left jab and a good 1-2 punch. 1 minute to go in round one. Tiger concentrating on the body to slow down his fast opponent over the 10-round route. Ten seconds to go in round one. There's the bell. Coming up to round two of Madison Square Garden, tall Billy Pickett in the white trunks, rugged Dick Tiger in the black. Tiger's now crouching a little bit. Is starting to find his man with heavy punches. Pickett gamely fighting back, but he was tagged in there. Tiger sometimes uses that left hook in a chopping motion. Pickett, who was boring in round one, has taken to backing up now. He sampled heavy leather earlier in the round. There's a minute left in round two. Tiger is quick with those heavy punches. Backing into his own corner. There. Here's the bell ending round two. Let's go back to the corner with Billy Pickett and see who's in there. There's Alvin Bachman taking the mouthpiece out. His father, Frank Bachman, making a father and son combination on the outside. Frank Sr. managed the likes of Maxie Rosenblum, and et cetera. And the trainer is Freddie Brown, the co-manager of Billy Pickett. Bob Redfield is in the audience, but is not in the corner. On the other side of the ring, we have Dick Tiger, who's up here from Nigeria. The veteran Jersey Jones is talking to him from the outside on the right, and Jimmy August, his trainer, is on the left. Jones is his American representative and is almost as well-known and maybe just as well-known to hockey fans as he is to boxing fans, because Jersey was a hockey publicist for the Garden for many, many years. Pickett wearing the white trunks, Tiger the black trunks, round three, Madison Square Garden. Jab is not keeping Tiger away. Billy went into his dance there though for the second time tonight. Joel Nixon reminds me that Tiger did a dance against Armstrong the night he knocked him out. Does very little jabbing, but throws heavy punches. 1 minute to go in round three. Pickett has a cheering section in the back. Tiger not as accurate in this round as he was last round. He hasn't fought since last spring. Ring rust could be showing. Pickett has been regularly active. Seconds to go in round three. There's the bell. Billy Pickett in white, Dick Tiger in black trunks. Thank you. while he comes in a step at a time. Starting to score with the heavy ones once again. However, he shows a healthy respect for Pickett's punching. There's another good left hook by Tiger. Take the mandatory 8 count. 7, 8. We've got about 20 seconds left to go in the round. Pickett gamely fighting back, but his knees are wobbly. Now 10 seconds left. There's the bell ending round 4. Let's take a look at Billy Pickett. He was knocked down all right, but apparently he is all right. The boxing writers of New York are having their annual dinner Sunday night, January 14th, and the main awards are going to Gene Fulmer, the middleweight champion of the NBA, and Dr. Schiff of the New York Commission, and yours truly is getting a special award that night, for which we thank the boxing writers. Here's something of interest to all sports fans. Saturday is sports day on ABC. The best in boxing and the best in bowling, not only on Make That Fair after the fight, but also on the Professional Bowlers Tour, which begins Saturday afternoon, January 6th. Tomorrow, the American Football League TV games, the New York at Dallas and Boston at San Diego. Coming up, the colorful Orange Bowl festivities. Check your local paper for time and station on ABC, television's number one network for sports. Here's round 5 now. Let's see if Pickett has recovered from that knockdown. It was a good clean one. One thing we always remark about Tiger, he's a very, very patient fighter, a very confident one. And a very strong one. Tiger was not going to only end it. He tried to put Pickett in the balcony that time. Thank you. there losing some of that accuracy again. Seconds to go in round five. There's the bell. Round six, Madison Square Garden. Dick Tiger of Nigeria, the British Empire middleweight champion in the black trunk. Billy Pickett of New York in the white. Tiger 160.5, Pickett 159.5. One knockdown in the bout so far, scored by Tiger in the fourth round. Left in round six. May not look it, but he has a pretty good defense, too. Blocking a lot of those punches. There's a minute left in this round. Showing signs of wear once again. There's the bell ending round six. Hey, Madison Square Garden. Billy Pickett, who had rough going in round seven in the white trunk. Dick Tiger in the black. follow through on that, Mr. Punch. Now Pickett is finding him with that jab again. About a minute left in round eight. Tiger shortened up on those punches. There's the bell ending round eight. Many of the officials of the National Boxing Association are at ringside tonight. Dr. Charles P. Lawson, the president from Tacoma, Washington. Abe J. Green, our old friend from Paterson, New Jersey, who is the national commissioner. Arch Hindman, executive secretary from Hagerstown, Indiana. And Paul Sullivan, chairman of the World Championships Committee from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Admiral Bergen of Madison Square Garden and his lovely wife also in attendance. And all enjoying the fight. We're coming up to round nine. Charlie Hoff of the News leaning in there. Somebody asked me once who the man with the box was. That's Charlie Hoff of the Daily News taking a picture. Pickett in the white trunks, Tiger in the black trunks. One knockdown scored by Tiger in the fourth round. Here's round nine. While a pound lighter is 3 inches taller at 5'11". There goes Pickett, rocked again to the right. Sort of a delayed action punch that time. To go on round nine. 10 seconds to go in round nine. There's the bell. Mark Kahn, the referee, will have the battlers touch gloves. In round 10, the final round of Madison Square Garden, Billy Pickett of New York, the white trunks, Dick Tiger of Nigeria in black. There has been one knockdown scored by Tiger in the fourth round. Pickett getting up at about two and taking the mandatory eight count. Pickett has been in trouble on a couple of other occasions. Was to have met Florentino Fernandez tonight. Pickett is a substitute, but Fernandez had travel difficulties and couldn't get here. He's going to meet the winner in January. That ought to be a real blockbuster if he meets Tiger. Less than 2 minutes left in the fight. Is half over. Pickett gamely stays in there and tries. The final bell. Crowd seems to have liked it. The gladiators have no ill will to each other. The scoring in New York is on a round basis. Remember, ABC every Saturday for the fight of the week. We're waiting for the decision. The commissioners, Pat Callahan, Joe Alpern, Frank Morris, the deputies. Here's Johnny Addy.
Both judges, Tony Rossi and Frank Forbes, score it 8-2, favor of Tiger. Referee Mark Kahn, 7-3, Tiger. Winner by unanimous decision, Dick Tiger.
There's a very happy Dick Tiger with Johnny up in the center of the ring. Pickett comes over to congratulate him. Tiger will meet Florentino Fernandez in January. Be on television ringside next Saturday night and enjoy the 10-round welterweight match between Emil Griffith and Isaac Logar from St. Nicholas Arena on the Fight of the Week. Produced by Hugh Beach. Directed by Marshall Dist.